When I was a kid, I used to think the term concrete jungle meant that there were lots and lots of trees in the city centre. Eventually, I came to understand what it really meant. An overgrowth of concrete buildings, all racing for the sky and crammed into the tightest of spaces in our urban areas. That's how we tend to measure development. The higher we build, the more developed we are. Countries all around the world constantly trying to outdo one another for the honor of being home to the world's tallest building. But is that what development is all about? Do we measure it by the number of cranes in our skyline? KL has undergone dramatic changes in the past 30 years. And to be honest, I do often meet foreigners who come to KL because of the Twin Towers. But I guess the question is, how do we balance our goals of being a developed nation against our need to protect all that is sacred to us? Environment, peace, our tropical richness. And to be fair, this is no longer limited to KL alone. There is robust development in Penang, in Johor, with many of us coming to realize that it is, more and more, at the expense of permanently altering our lifestyles. So what price development? Let me start by saying this. I'm a bit of a gadget freak. Yes, in fact, I already have an iPhone 5. Why should this even matter? Well, because it's a very good example of this tricky balance between development versus the environment. I am a consumer, and my demands are what fuels the market for scarce resources. I and the 5 million others like me who race to buy the iPhone 5 on launch weekend. There's a huge demand for raw materials, one of which is rare earth materials used to manufacture batteries, camera lenses, and glass, all components that go into producing my iPhone. It is a somewhat similar situation in the palm oil industry. There is no denying that it's a huge revenue generator and the benefits do impact smallholders, who make up 40% of the players in the upstream industry. But we are also rightfully concerned when rainforests are cleared to make way for palm oil plantations. But this is where policy and sustainability matter, which is why there are new mandates to regulate the use of land for palm oil plantation. What about the oil refinery in Pengerang?
We all know that we cannot continue to rely on crude oil for revenue, and the oil refinery is our attempt to play a central role in oil and gas in Asia.
On the one hand, we cannot lose out on the economic opportunities in an increasingly competitive climate. But on the other hand, the existing local fishing economy is a matter not to be taken lightly. Or maybe this is where the balance comes in. Our constant need to revitalize local economies, to search for new opportunities. The local fishing economy is not as robust as it once was. Fishermen aren't getting the same amount of catch as they used to. So perhaps there is an argument for revitalizing communities by introducing new skills and new industry. One thing is for sure. There should be a way for doing this in a collaborative manner. Investing in new areas with the community as a partner so that everyone is invested in the change. What we need is to ensure that we can maximize the economic potential while maintaining a sustainable approach.